This little miner used to make over $100 a day and only costs a couple bucks a week to run, but it's making much less now. Is it still worth getting? Is something replaced it? I'm Vosk. You're on the Voskcoin YouTube channel, where I work on content about getting your money working for you, earning passive income, things like that, at least for me and what I'm doing in my point of view, and also document myself building my own mining farm. Let's dig into this one. This miner in particular is the Goldshell AL Box. It costs over 10 grand originally just a few months ago. It was earning like 100 bucks a day back in like April, and then it quickly dropped to about $40 a day in May, and then a new device came out that could do over $30 a day. These miners that are referenced, right, is the Goldshell AL Box. It used to cost over 10 grand. You can get it for under 2 grand now. Also, the AL Box 2, which is literally just two of these packed into one. You can get that under 2 grand now. And then there's also their latest release, the AL Box 2 Plus. These names are just freaking fantastic, aren't they? Which is basically three of like the original boxes slammed into one. And that's at about $2,000, making that an even better buy. Right, so when we look at all of the mining rigs, we see there's this something called an Antminer AL1 that's actually still mining over $100 a day. And we look at these AL boxes, depending which one you have and your electricity rate right now, they're mining between $3 and $10 a day. Stark decrease from what stark contrast from what we had before. And then after you account for an electricity bill, depending on which model you have, it may cost up to like around $1 a day to run, which has now become a substantial piece of your cost there. We look at the most profitable coins to mine, right? We have things from Bitcoin all the way down to like ALF, which is what these miners in question mine. F2 Pool says it's putting out $80,000 per day. Remember, all the miners we're talking about here are ASIC miners. They're application-specific integrated circuit miners, purpose-built machines. All they do is mine cryptocurrency, normally one mining algorithm. In this case, right, it's ALF, and then that produces, according to what to mine, about 1.13 Bitcoin in emissions per day, which is about in line with this number. The other latest news is a new Dragon Ball miner. Surprisingly, the name sounds ridiculous. You wonder if it's even real, but it is real. We have a Dragon Ball KS6 on our mining farm. They boast that this can dual mine, where it mines ALF as well as Radiant at the same time, which is just now flipped over to being ASIC mined with this miner, the first one publicly released here. This is a crazy price point. I think these will come crashing down. Radiant doesn't produce that much in dollarized coins per mine per day. Very, very small ecosystem, right? You contrast that with something like Caspa, right? Caspa's putting out $1.2 million in newly mined coins per day right now. But this is interesting because it's going to make ALF mining even more competitive. It's going to make the Goldshell AL boxes, you know, earn even less. It's going to take some market share away from the AL1. And so we look at the specs on this: 3.2 terahash on Radiant and 1.2 terahash on ALF. They've essentially built the Goldshell AL Box 2 Plus, actually even better, into a whole miner that mines an additional cryptocurrency. And they're definitely asking a premium for that. By the way, I'm always happy to show you guys the manufacturer sites. We're an affiliate with ASIC Marketplace. Please use our link if you enjoy our content and you want us to keep making more free content. We have a coupon code to save you some coin. It's better than any codes they put on their site. It's down in the video description below, but please, you have to use our link for us to get credit. If you use our code, they don't care. They do not credit us. And one of the reasons you normally want to buy from resellers as opposed to, say, like directly from Bitmain, you pay, at least here in the US, every time, a 25% tariff. And normally you have to buy millions of dollars of miners to even get a better deal to begin with. And then it's not a better deal once you pay those tariffs, right? If we just look at something that's very expensive here, like the AL1, this was just in stock a couple of days ago. He's selling at 44 grand for one, 31 grand if you bought a ton of them. All right, and you could go over here, you could buy it for 32 grand before any coupon codes and things like that. And I know it's a ridiculously priced miner, just for reference. But you know, on the topic of ALF and these miners and if it still mines 100 bucks a day and all that stuff, it's relevant. The Ice River ALF AL0, this miner is from Ice River, who slashed their prices big time on their Caspa miners. This is a more efficient ALF miner than the Goldshell miners. But it is not quite as efficient as the Bitmain Antminer AL1. These are proving to be very profitable. And what's really interesting is they boast that the AL Zero is compatible with NiceHash. I had a good experience mining ALF on DX Pool. It's the only pool that the AL Box worked on originally. But then somewhere between the miner, the firmware, and the pool, it just stopped working, huge reject rate. And so I updated the firmware to the latest firmware, and at the same time, I flipped it over to mining on a 2 pool, and the mining performance has stabilized. It still is underperforming what it is supposed to be doing, but it's pretty close. And most importantly, I'm getting a stable 24-hour hash rate. And you can see that I've got two days of mining on here now, the day I flipped it over, and then for one full day, I was able to hit about 354 gigahash a second. It's supposed to be averaging out about 360 gigahash a second. Per day on that miner. So I'm gonna remote into my mining farm here, and I'm gonna log into my Ice River AL0. Default password, I believe, is 1 through 8. I just save it in there so I don't have to think about it, and I get in there easier. So this is apparently compatible with NiceHash, right? So I don't mine to my NiceHash account. I mine to an external wallet, but I need to log in to get to this page. I guess I don't know. I'm struggling. I used to be able to access that page without logging in. Maybe they don't let you do it that way anymore. So I'm logging in. I've logged in. I click download or add ASIC, connect your ASIC device, right? If you put in ALF, you don't get anything. You put in Blake 2S, that comes up, but ALF is a Blake 3 mining algorithm variant. So I don't know how this is NiceHash compatible when I don't see Blake 3 here. I see Blake 2S. So I guess this is the page I was looking for, and weirdly enough, if I put in Blake 3, it does not show it. But when you actually spell out the cryptocurrency, it is here. So let's try it. Okay, so I just put that information in. Apparently the operation succeeded. Let's see if that actually works. And while we do that, let's go ahead and try this test out on the original Gold Shell AL box with the updated firmware, which I just get from the Gold Shell Miner GitHub. Okay, so we saved that mining pool, and now we're gonna drag it up here to the top and see if it works. Okay, so at a quick glance, we can see that the AL0 and AL box have pinged the pool. It's very common when you try to connect to mining pools that your miner may communicate with the pool, but will it work with the pool? They're two different things. If it is online and not working, it'll be here, it will show mining, but it will be earning zero, right? And if it is working to any degree, you'll have some sort of profitability. I haven't clicked on the fiat settings, right? You come down here and select your fiat currency, or you can click this and switch it over to how much Bitcoin you're mining per day. This used to be a lot more interesting and enjoyable until Bitcoin became so expensive. And it's like, oh, I'm mining 0.00002592 or 2,592 Satoshis per day on that one. And we can see here that the AL0 has started to register mining profitability. The AL box still has not. Something to note, right? We see the KA box over here. This is another Gold Shell miner. They have miners that are compatible with NiceHash. Refreshing here in the Gold Shell AL box, again, firmware version latest, which is 2.2.7. And it is online now. It has restarted. It is mining. It says that it is connected and working with this pool. This is really interesting because a lot of people, they don't want to hold ALF. Right, they don't want another coin. There's already they feel like there's too many. There's not good exchange support. There's very low exchange support if you're a U.S. citizen. A lot of people would just take Bitcoin over ALF. This is one of the downsides, right, with all of the options in the mining game these days. You see a new coin. What years ago you would have had to hold the coin, right? You would have been a supporter there, even if indirectly or made to be. But now there's easy button ways out to mine something else, right? And say like if you do this, you can instead just indirectly buy Bitcoin miners that are technically altcoin miners, right? It simplifies your taxes. It decreases how much you need to do, right? This can be paid out directly from this mining pool to cold storage. That's an extra layer of security. There's a lot of benefits and things going against altcoins being mined on auto converting pools like this, because if you're getting paid in Bitcoin, you best believe that they are just mining these coins and dumping them, right? They're dumping them. They're taking a cut. NiceHash is technically a hash rate marketplace, but the bottom line is, right, they're taking a cut, they're selling hash if they can, and they're dumping coins, and they're paying you in BTC. And that can be a very negative thing for projects, and it's why we see a lot of just price suppression in numerous cryptocurrencies. There's a lot more to it, tons of variables and things like that, but it's just something to think about, some food for thought. But sadly, you know, with looking at the price this cost when I received mine versus how much ALF coin I've mined, that coin has gone down in price since I've received it, maybe because of things like this NiceHash support, for one. I've not broken even on what these things cost when I got it versus now, and the daily mining profitability versus this being the first to market miner, as well as the low electrical cost that would keep it, you know, a viable miner for a long time, it instilled some confidence. But the bottom line is, the old rule that if you buy a first batch miner, no matter what, you're good, is no longer true. That used to be true. It's no longer true. We've seen numerous miners released over the last year, and even beyond then, a year and a half, even maybe 2 years, that have not been a quick path to break even. Some of them have not broken even. And one of the best strategies so far has been to mine and hold the coin. That specifically did very well with Casa because it's touched some new all-time highs. But mining out and trading into Bitcoin was less lucrative than mining and hodling Casa, for example. But it was more lucrative than mining and selling to USD. So Casa gains outpaced BTC gains in that regard. Could ALF do the same? It doesn't have that big of a market cap to move, but that means it's easily moved up as well as down. So I don't know, we'll see. Interesting nonetheless. Mining has not been dull this year. It's actually been tiring how many new miner models we've seen released and everything like that. To give you a quick snapshot here, is these things are still kind of firing up. The AL0 went up to $3. It's mining $2.28. The AL box is mining $1.47 here on the pool. Refresh $2.28 and $2.39 there. This is a miner that is supposed to be earning $3.67 a day after a tiny electric bill. And we look at the AL box, and that's supposed to be pulling about $3 a day after a tiny electric bill. At a glance, these are performing more or less as they are supposed to. You see variance here on this pool. It's not surprising to see a variance of, like, you know, 50 cents or so on a coin like this, you know, percentage wise. So, hey, I'm Boss. You're on the Boss Coin YouTube channel. Things change quickly in crypto. Please subscribe to Boss Coin. Stay up to date on all of those. I'll bring you the good, bad, the ugly, and the cute, which is not me. I know, obviously not me. It's Tails. We run 10 seconds of Tails in every video. Thanks so much for tuning in, and I hope to see you on the next video. Yeah.